Well, on this final day of May, we are looking ahead to June. June is National Men's Health Month, and June 2nd is National Cancer Survivor Day. Today, we are recognizing one Kernersville man's story of survival.
For Chris Williams,
you need a little trim, don't you?
The art of barbering is in his blood.
The photograph behind you is my dad cutting my hair for the first time in 1960, and he's standing there with the two barbers that worked with him at the time.
His dad, Roger Williams, opened Williams Barbershop along Main Street in Kernersville in 1960.
He cut hair here 60 years.
Chris grew up in the shop.
He had me shining shoes, you know, at 6 years old.
But he didn't plan to follow in his father's footsteps.
I had not always planned to be a barber, no. I went to UNCG and majored in business.
Sometimes life has another plan.
It was in my blood, I guess, you know, and in my subconscious, maybe, you know, all along, maybe, even though I didn't think I was going to be a barber, I guess it was in there, you know, because I had experienced it so long.
Cutting hair alongside his dad for 25 years. And then, in 2021, Chris's life took another unexpected turn.
I was diagnosed April 6th, 2021.
Head and neck cancer. Adding to the concerns?
Chris is an amazing singer.
Would Chris's voice ever be the same?
It's a very aggressive treatment, you know.
It is the most difficult treatment, one of the most difficult treatments that we have here that patients can undergo because it affects your ability to eat, to drink, to speak, to breathe, all of those which are essential for daily function.
Meredith Smith was Chris's cancer nurse navigator at Novant Health Cancer Institute.
Chris handled it very well. He had the anticipated side effects and struggles that all our patients do, but attitude is at least half the battle.
It took 35 rounds of radiation, 7 chemotherapy treatments, all within 5 weeks, for Chris's prognosis to improve.
He wasn't going to be defeated by this.
And it didn't take him long to get back to the barber shop. But his voice still hadn't fully recovered. And then something unexpected happened.
I hit the notes better now that the cancer's not there. I think I sing just a tad higher too.
You probably do.
The treatments improved Chris's voice, and he shared that gift, hoping to provide strength to those who are in the fight for their life.
There was one support group where he sang Amazing Grace. It was very impromptu. One of the other members asked him to sing, and it was just this most amazing rendition of Amazing Grace.
In Kernersville,
You're
Kevin
welcome.
Conley, Fox 8 News.
Well, Chris has been cancer-free for 3 years now. He still keeps in touch with his nurse, Meredith, and frequently attends Novant Health Cancer Institute's Cancer Support Group, hoping to help others who are battling the disease.